There's a lot of advice for how to prepare for interviews as an entry-level software engineer. Bone up on coding, review your basic data structures, have some ambitious talk about what you want to be when you grow up. But what about for senior and principal-level engineers? Hi, I'm John Miller, the deliberate engineer. I spent the last 30 years as a software engineer in big tech, in academia, and research. I was a principal engineer for 15 of those years, and throughout my career, I've both interviewed and been interviewed by people. I've got lots of experience hiring and being hired, or not. Today, I'm going to talk about the right way to prepare to be interviewed for senior and principal level positions. 1. Don't learn required skills just for the interview. 2. Take the rust off your toolkit, and no, that's not a euphemism. 3. Review your processes and opinions. 4. Tailor your resume to the job that you're applying for. 5. Know where you're going. And 6. Practice scoped design and implementation. People talk about faking it until you make it. 40 years ago, you'd read up on whatever languages or tools were required for a given job before the interview. You hoped that your interviewer didn't know the technologies well and they weren't an expert on it. The goal was to learn enough to pass the interview. Then, once you're getting paid, learn how to actually do the job. This was never really a good idea, although it works sometimes. As the industry grew, it became harder and harder to do successfully. So don't think you'll just pull the wool over the interviewer's eyes. You might luck out and fool them, but it's far more likely you'll just get confused and be at a loss when they start probing, and then it'll be obvious that you don't really know what you're talking about. Now you've replaced one problem with two more. First, the interviewer doesn't believe you or your resume anymore. Second, even if you're a brilliant algorithmist and coder, it looks like you can't program worth a damn. You generally can't learn a new skill just for an interview. Instead, focus on the skills you already have and use them. You'll go a lot further writing great code in the C# you know than stumbling around in the C++ that you just learned for this interview. Expanding on that theme, interviewing using the technologies you know is just good common sense. If you haven't used them in a while, though, make sure you take some time to refresh your memory. I've found that between an hour and a day is a good amount of time to dedicate to reviewing a programming language. And as for refreshing your memory about a tool that you used, a few minutes to a few hours is plenty for something like source control. Most of us use lots of different tools and languages. If you have nothing in common with the requirements for your job, use what you know best. If there's some overlap between what the job is asking for and your personal proficient experience, make a judgment call whether to use the languages they want or the language that you're best in. Companies are generally willing to let a good prospective employee learn a new language on the job if they're confident that that employee is excellent at software engineering in general. If you're going to be interviewed online and you're familiar with online tools for diagramming or coding, refresh your memory on those as well. This is one spot where you should figure out whether you need to learn a new tool, their tools for the interview, or figure out a way to work in the tools that you're most familiar with and then import any diagrams or drawings, whatever, into their program. Whatever you know, it's worth making sure that you can demonstrate it. If you haven't coded for a couple months, it's worth a few hours or a day to write some simple code and remind yourself of all the intricacies of the language. As a more senior engineer, you'll help not just with doing things, but in shaping how they're done. If the employer claims to be one that uses agile methodology, remind yourself of the things that you love and hate about agile, the different ways you've seen it practiced, and how to figure out if it's a good fit for the particular environment that you'll be working in. If the employer front loads design and planning, then make sure you know the success factors for that approach as well. Be prepared to have opinions about how they do things, but in a very positive, collaborative manner. You won't have enough information to say, it should be exactly like this, but you should be able to ask friendly questions like, what led you to do things this way? How's it working out for you? What are your biggest challenges right now? Have you tried or considered doing X? You'll be able to position yourself as someone who can add a lot of value to the company. As a side note, I'd be remiss if I didn't mention that some places actually will want you to say how things should be. Read the room to figure out how assertive to be when you're voicing your opinions. If you're applying to high senior and principal level positions, you've probably got a lot of varied experiences, especially in today's world of job hopping every few years. You've got to make sure that your resume communicates the parts of your experience that are the most relevant to the company and the position that you're applying for, without a lot of extra details that aren't. Mistakes I've made in the past that I recommend against. First, having lots of details about past experience that you don't want to use and don't really remember. The way that I was worst bitten by this was mentioning a scripting language in my resume that I'd worked on for a few months 10 years earlier. I wound up interviewing with a luminary in programming languages, and the interviewer spent the entire time asking me a programming language design question, despite the job itself being in networking and distributed systems. That single interview alone was enough to no hire me, whether I passed the other interviews or not. Second, not enough details on the current relevant stuff. Make sure that the most relevant fifth of your experience takes up something like half of your resume. You don't want to be discussing why your experience isn't enough for a job after being turned down, only to find out that the reason they no-hired you was because they thought you didn't know anything about a technology you actually had lots of experience with. You just left it off your resume for space reasons. Next, unexplained gaps. Don't leave out the 5 years you worked at the startup that turned out to be a stupid idea, but do minimize it on your resume. It's okay for the description to just be a single line, various work for an early stage startup with the dates. Or if you took a couple years off to take care of a loved one, a single line with dates that says full-time caregiver or something like that is perfectly adequate. Much respect to anybody who has the heart to do this. When a company is considering whether to interview you, your resume is a big factor, especially if you don't have some sort of internal referral. Each interview is going to be based on your resume, possibly seen for the first time by your interviewer just before they start talking to you and asking questions. Structure your resume so that a quick glance is likely to fall on something relevant to the position you're applying for. Keep your resume very short, or have a short resume and then some sort of an addendum. At almost 40 years of experience, I sometimes let my resume bleed over onto a third page, but I make damn sure that the stuff that the interviewer is going to care about is on that first page. As an interviewer, I've seen resumes more than 5 pages, sometimes as much as 20 pages, and I can tell you, I either didn't read the whole thing, if it was well-structured and I could find what I needed, or I read it and I resented the candidate for having made me read it, much to their detriment during the interview. When you're just starting out in your career, it's natural to have huge ambitions and to not really know if you want to be a manager or an executive or some sort of distinguished engineer. It can be forgiven to talk to a company without having an intelligent reason why you want to work at that company in particular, other than something like, to make money, or because you're the best. Those aren't intelligent reasons. When you're further along in your career, that sort of lapse doesn't fly anymore. Make sure that you can talk about where you think you are in your career and where you want to be. If principal engineer is the end all for you, then just say that you're happy with that, or that you're hoping to work towards being a distinguished engineer. Be able to talk about the scope and the type of work that you want to be doing now and in the future. Do you want to be a domain expert with a very narrow but deep domain? Or do you want to be guiding some sort of a broad product strategy for the company? Maybe you want to spend time mentoring the next generation of leaders. All of these are fine, but make sure that you know what you want, how it relates to the expectations of this particular position, and that you can express it sensibly. In the past, I personally failed at this. I've literally said, oh, I'm happy with whatever. Managing, coding, I like them both. In my opinion, that's an awful answer. What it actually says to the interviewer is, I don't care. I don't care about the job, and I don't care enough about this interview to try and find an opinion. Instead, it'd be better to say something like, designing algorithms is my first love. I like shaping the direction of a product and helping come up with the best ways to make it more efficient and correct. I like coding, but I really only prefer to work on the very fiddly bits that are best solved by somebody with my experience. I like mentoring people, but I'm not looking to have anybody reporting to me. If it's something that's needed in the future, we could have a discussion about it. But again, my preference is to be a senior individual contributor. Read up on the company before you interview there. This should be obvious, but you'd be surprised how many people get ready to make a multi-year commitment that's going to completely change their life without knowing the first thing about the company or its prospects, how it does business, what its revenue model is, and what the best products are in it in terms of revenue and growth. As a senior or principal engineer, you should know better, and you should be prepared. When you're being interviewed as a senior candidate, it's easy to get caught up in the minutiae of a really interesting, difficult problem. You have to remember, you're not being interviewed for a line coder position. You're being interviewed to be somebody who can be a technical leader. You need to be able to guide the scope of an interview discussion in a way that shows your value to the company. One mistake that I've made frequently when answering coding and design questions is to dive too quickly. If you solve the deepest part of a question that's too big to really be solved in an interview, it may be impressive, but it doesn't demonstrate all those senior and principal skills that you're being interviewed for. For example, I've been asked variations on connected components problems at least 3 times. The algorithms are relatively easy to describe, but they're very tricky to code. All 3 times, I dived deep right away and tried to write working code to solve the problem. I ignored things like clarity of data formats, API design, and pretty much everything else you'd expect from a senior engineer to focus on the core algorithm. Bad move. The interfaces I made were crap, as I said. The design wasn't separable into pieces that could be worked on by other people. To top it off, half the time, The person interviewing me wasn't at all impressed, among other reasons because they'd never tried to write this code themselves and they didn't know how difficult it was. A better way to answer this sort of question is to have a scoping dialogue. Acknowledge the deep technical problem is interesting and be willing to work on it, but suggest that you focus on things like class design, data structures, the APIs, and how it fits into the bigger overall picture. If the interview doesn't want to do this, fine. Work on whatever they want, and you've lost maybe a couple minutes. And you still have plenty of time to deep dive. In the best case, this will drive the interview into letting you show off some of the less obvious parts of your approach to design and engineering. You know, the sort of things a company expects a senior principal engineer to do. Practice taking significant coding design problems and addressing them at various scopes that show not just the algorithmic excellence, but also an awareness of how business is done, that it's solving a problem in a larger environment and context. Have a set of questions or an approach to working with the interviewer to figure out what part of the overall picture they most want you to talk about. Practice with a friend or colleague if you can. It's worth mentioning that you may be expected to just code up the answer to a relatively simple problem. I've also had principal interview loops where a relatively junior developer has been assigned to make sure that I'm not just all talk and I can still code. If that's what they're looking for in the interview, make sure that you're ready to provide that too. There's a lot more we could discuss, but I think this is plenty for a single video. Summing it up, principal interviews aren't just tougher than junior software interviews. They have a different emphasis and a different set of expectations. Before the interview, make sure that you do the following. Review what you know and don't try to learn a bunch of new stuff that's mentioned in the job spec just for that interview. Focus on the languages and the tools that overlap with what the company is looking for, and make sure you've scanned over the details of those tools enough that you can readily answer questions about them and demonstrate proficiency. Think about the higher level business of specifying, designing, writing, and shipping software. Make sure you review the tools that you've used for this in the past, and be prepared to be friendly but opinionated, and to have a dialogue about the right way to get work done in general. Make sure that your written artifacts, especially your resume, focus on the parts of your experience relevant to what you want to do and what the company needs done. Minimize irrelevant experience and gaps to reduce distractions during the interview. And of course, have an idea about why you want to work at this company in the first place, what you hope to get out of it, where you're at in your career, and where you're going. Finally, when you're actually interviewing, make sure you work at the scope they expect for that interview. If you're tempted to dive too deeply and solve the guts of a problem, practice talking about the higher levels so the interviewer will be able to see what you offer in that regard. If you're watching this, you're probably a senior or a principal level engineer. Do you agree with the suggestions that I have here? Do you think they're productive or not productive? Do you have any other advice that you could give to me and to other senior engineers to help them do better in interviews? Drop a note down in the comments below or send me a message. I'd love to hear what you think. Thanks for watching and keep on pushing forward.
Hi, this is John. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please think about subscribing so you get notified of my future videos. Also, if you are interested, you might want to check out the video I have linked here. Thanks and keep on pushing forward.